ask you a bunch of questions. I want to have them answered immediately.
But why should I?
Because I'm going to say, please.
Drop it, Chopper!
You did not make it, Victor.
Sweetheart, we're married.
Consider that a divorce.
It might be a tumor.
It's not a tumor. Not a tumor at all. Chill out. It's not a tumor.
This is war. Let's kick some ice.
Crush your enemies. See them driven before you. They hear the lamentation of the women.
Go on to be bad.
Guta! Guta! Guta!
If it bleeds, we can kill it.
Now this is the plan. Get your ass to Mars.
You're late.
Traffic.
May I see your invitation, please?
Sure. Here's my invitation.
What killed the dinosaurs? The Ice Age!
Yep. Had it coming strong. Had it coming tough.
Genolexis talks. We do what the fuck we want.
Because
we do what the fuck we want on Genolexis talks.
So beautiful. So beautiful.
That was quite the intro.
Yeah, a long one. Nice long intro. A nice shout out to Arnold, you know what I'm saying? He unofficially, you know, sponsors the show.
Because I'm a stud.
And that's what it is.
I'm ballsy.
And that's what we do.
Because I'm a stud.
Yeah, how you been, bro?
Fantastic.
Sounds good. Sounds good. It's been going great. Of course, there's enough things going on in the mainstream media we can meme off of. So, we'll start with, I don't know.
This in the studio!
I like it. That's a great thing. Yeah, if any of y'all was on the live, you can see for yourself, we are now in the new studio. And I'm horrible at like posting up and letting people know like, hey, we're on. Because the unfortunate part of my show, we don't ever actually have a schedule. We just go, you know what I'm saying? But we're doing better. We're doing better at like doing more shows during the month. So it's not going to be like a show every 3 months, you know what I'm saying? That's how it was before, like a few months ago. But still, we're getting better. Bigger and better. Great things are happening. And we would have started earlier, but I don't know. When you have situations and problems like me, and you take your kids to work, you just got to take care of the kids before you work. You know what I'm talking about? Uh-oh, what happened?
Nothing.
Oh, you see? That's why I like what we do on our show, though. We just straight go off of anything.
I was looking at my phone. Don't worry. Not paying attention.
No, that's what happens, man. It's all good, man. That's what it's about, Shawty. That's what it's about. We are live and direct. And shout out to everybody that's tuning in from wherever you're tuning in from. And whoever was on the live, if you don't know already, like, go on the Eugene, Genolexis, Alexis Facebook page. And if you want to wild out, like, you know, come join us. Or just check out what we're doing. Because we definitely was wilding out. And I had a blast. So I hope you guys have a blast as well. But I got music that I want to play. But I ain't going to play it now because I want to talk about a few things. Few great things. Like, are y'all going to the movies? Because I heard that Joker movie was out, but I haven't seen it, so I don't know. So if
I haven't seen it. I'm kind of hoping. Well, I don't think it comes out till Friday.
Oh, yeah, Friday? All right, cause I hear everyone's freaking out, like, oh no, there's going to be killings and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, man, if you're going to go to the movies, you're going to go to the movie. There are people dying on the way to the movies, in a car accident or something like that. I don't plane fall from the sky and land on everybody or something. Things happen. So stop being crazy, man. If anything like that happened, you just got to be prepared. And I'm just saying, what if you are in the theater and a shootout happens? What you going to do? What you going to do, cuz? What if it happens like during a violent part where you think it's the movie and it's really
good shots? Somebody
and you're like, laughing like, oh, that's crazy. Like, ah! And it's like people just dropping around you. What are you going to do? So I want to be able to talk about stuff like that. And if you guys are, you know, already planning and you're not even, you know, really thinking about like watching a movie, but you're thinking like, what if something pops off? I'm gonna be ready, son. I'm gonna be ready. So I'd like to know what you plan on doing. Or y'all just gonna just ignore it and just chill?
I'm just gonna watch the movie at home on Fire Stick.
That's what I'll do.
It's too dangerous to go out,
bro. People wilding, bro. People wilding. People just do anything just to be on TV, even if it's for like 5 seconds. I want to be on TV. I want to be the Joker, mask killer, blah, blah, blah. That's some punk shit, though. You're going to hit people up while they're sitting there trying to watch a movie, mind their business. They there with their kids, watching a rated R movie for whatever reason.
That's whole shit, man.
Bro, you know what I'm saying? Like, you really about that life? Walk into a police station and do that.
How you going to text me and then not even give me a chance to respond to the text?
Word.
Then you going to call me.
Oh, that's severe. That's severe business. That's serious. Somebody really, really, really needs to reach you, bro. Really, 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 really needs to reach you. But anyway, if you're going out to go watch that Joker
Jason,
movie.
He's coming through.
Oh, bet. Bet. We got a guest going to be coming through. He don't even know he's going to be on the show, but you know what? That's what we do on the show. So it might be like the janitor or the fucking, I don't know.
Is the door locked?
It might be locked. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, because I don't trust people, cuz. People coming up in here, I'm acting crazy.
I'm looking at the door to see if I see feet.
Word, that's it. That'd be funny, like they're knocking and you see them get on their knees and try to look with their face. Like, I caught you.
Like the kids.
You know what I'm saying? You pull that kid joint. Y'all know what I'm talking about, especially your parents, you know?
Come in!
You know how it is.
Damn!
Yeah, that means you got work.
Now I gotta get up. I was kind of hoping it wasn't locked.
That was quick. He came quick. Well, yeah, our guest is here. So it's going to be real fun talking about this. I don't think y'all understand. We got some talented people in the building. But yeah, I'm going to do the live thing because, like, I think it's dope when people could see that we're here doing the live thing. And I got the little one with me, and she's just chilling, being a good old girl. What's good, man? What's good, J-Dog? Chilling. And one of these microphones are on, but ask this guy. Ask the sound guy, because, like, he's very, very picky on which microphone you want to use, just in case.
Hi. Boom.
We got family.
We back now.
We got family. Oh, he's back. We been here. This nigga, he's like, we back now.
So, where you sitting at, bro?
Oh, yeah.
You're on now.
Yeah.
It's too late now.
We are unofficial guests, bro. Yeah. The first guest in the new studio for G Talks, bro. Wow. We're in the new studio. It's new big things. Wow. Big things, Agwan. Big things, Agwan. La, 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 la. La, 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 la. Yeah. We just do whatever.
What's your boys up to today?
Man, nothing. Just a bunch of nothing, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Basically.
That's what's up, bro. Nah, I'm glad to be here, man. Like, this is amazing, bro. Like,
bro, thank you, man.
It's nothing like I mean, it's everything I imagined, but even more so, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's what she said.
when I was walking down the hall, I was like, damn, this just looks just like it does on Facebook.
I feel like I've been here before.
I feel like I've been here before.
That's what it is.
I've been wanting to come over here for a minute, man.
We got people.
That's what it is. Yeah, J-Do, so tell people about yourself, man. We got a guest here, man. In case y'all don't know. That's my brother. We do music and a whole bunch of cool things, man. I have him say it himself, man.
I appreciate
people
that.
People that tuning in, like, you know, across the globe, and the people on the TV and on the live stream and wherever they listening to you, tell them who you are, bro.
Yeah, man, I'm J-Do, man. I go by International Do on Instagram and anywhere else. I'm a producer. I like to call myself more or less a developer now or less, because I feel like the producer can be broken down into so many different things. But nice. I think as an overall, most producers are someone that plays a background in a lot of artists' careers. And nice. So I pretty much like to call myself a developer, because nice. Not only do I develop artists, I develop ideas, businesses, things like this.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Just kind of curate different areas of the culture and of the business
nice.
Itself. You know what I'm saying? Bringing people's ideas to the table and making sure we can all kind of, you know, be on the same level. You know what I'm saying?
I see. When we linked up, it was like word of mouth. People was like, you know, like, hey, yo, you need to check my man's out. So I went to the studio. You still doing the studio?
Yes, sir. Still got the studio in Osmar Private OT Studios. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And so the extent of that now is Dream Design Development. That's the marketing and, you know what I'm saying, development.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Big things like wine. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, man. And I'm feeling that. You working with any artists right now? Just like, I know it's a mixture of people, but is there like a main person we should check out? You know,
yeah,
IG
definitely.
Whatnot?
Definitely, man. J Sky. That's J-A-Y Sky, S-C-A-I-A-I-X. And that's Sky with a dollar sign.
Oh, word.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? He's got
that pop
star vibe.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
That's what it is. Yeah, I already know you're always working hard, man. And your mix
Thanks,
is
man.
On point. So
thank you, man.
I need to get back in there as well. So definitely take my word for it, y'all. Like, you got good mix. He take care of your, you know, your music and whatnot. But good dude overall. And that's what we
thank
do
you.
Here. Like, because, like, anybody can have $1 million equipment, but if you're a piece of shit, you're a piece of shit.
With $1 million equipment.
With $1 million equipment. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Everybody act like, I'm American. Like, that's one of my favorite jokes from Chris Rock. Like, I'm American. Like, nigga, you just a nigga that came out your mom's pussy in Detroit. You know what I'm saying? Like, do something. You know what I'm saying? Just because you was born here don't mean you're all great. You're not so great, nigga.
Straight up.
Like, I don't care where you were born at. What you doing with your life? Bum ass. That's what's wrong. Everybody, they think they live somewhere. That's like, I'm a New Yorker. The fuck out of here. What you doing in New York? Take up space. Get out of here.
Yeah, man. I love that you got a platform, bro. You definitely are a vocal person, opinionated person, bro.
This is Tampa. Come on, man. We came from chains. I was watching Django earlier this week. It's on, nigga. I wish a nigga try me. Let me start. I'll turn to Sam Jackson quick. Oh, yes, I miss you like a flies miss shit. You didn't show that shit. Then they walk away. I talk shit again.
When they leave, I be talking again.
That face, man, I be making people pissed. Yeah. Like, oh, he like Trump. He like, look at, yeah, listen to my face. Look at my face. So I like nobody.
So since this is kind of impromptu altogether for me, this is my first time here.
Yeah, man.
How long have y'all been doing this, man?
Bro, like 3 years. Like the interview. Anyway. Yeah, but y'all caught down live. That's what's up. We got our shit falling apart here, but we got our own shit. Let me stop. But nah, definite. But like 3 years, bro. But it's crazy because like, really, it started. It started in freaking Surge's pool. We're in his old crib. Like we had a pool back then.
It's
the
like patio.
So it was in the patio. So like, and the pool wasn't even like a pool. It was like a frog pool. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We didn't go in there, but frogs did. But, like, anyway, the inspiration was just anything that we used to do, talk about, hang out, just the chill vibe mode. You know what I'm saying? It was like, it seemed like every time you want to hang out with your homies, you got to be somewhere. You got to be at a show, at the studio. Let's go to the studio. Yeah. I'm like, yo, why don't you just go to your homie's crib and just chill, hang out, talk about whatever, and then build from there.
Yeah.
Because that's what's like. That's where we did music. That's how we started doing our, you know, creative element. Whatever it is that we started doing that led to music videos or, you know, songs or whatnot, beats. It was because we was hanging out.
Right.
And then that led to us creating something that later on, you know, the world would enjoy. But it was like, all right, how do we go from there and then making it something that the world could feel that vibe?
Yeah.
So from that point on, it was like, all right, let's check out a few little, you know, platforms online. And then we got into the Spreaker format. We liked that. So we started doing that. And then finding out, you know what I'm saying, how it could get bigger with our followers or whatnot.
Yeah.
So, like, it didn't really matter the platform. It was just what worked for us. You know what I'm
saying? Man.
Because there was other people. Not even knocking the other platforms. There was plenty of great ones. Mm-hmm. But for what we had at the time, this is what worked for us.
Word.
So it's like, it was just the point about, all right, how do we stay consistent? Because, you know, we see other people doing it.
Yeah.
So how do we stay consistent with it and be excited every time we do it?
Right.
We didn't have a script. So it was just like, because I didn't want to make it seem like it's homework. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, you got to be here. You got to do this. You got to talk about that. And that's cool. Because there's a lot of, you know, successful podcasts. Shout out to all you guys that are mad, you know, with it. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. But book reports, I wasn't a fan of.
Except Joe Budden.
Allah have mercy.
He's just a bum ass nigga,
have
though.
Mercy.
Joe Budden's a bum ass.
Speaking of, man, shout out to my people, man. I'm producing a podcast myself.
Yeah.
Man. A little something
we're
putting together, man. Straight out the Fax Machine podcast.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We're just talking, you know what I'm saying?
Know.
Talking
trash. Whenever y'all need a place to come. Y'all want to do a guest podcast?
That was actually why I came to talk. You know what I'm saying?
Let's
I wanna
go!
You know what I'm saying?
Because you know we are the biggest internet podcast network in this city.
And just congratulations on that, by the way,
thank
man. I've been wanting to tell
you
all that if I haven't already.
Creative
you know
Loathing. We got nominated with that. You
that's
know
amazing,
saying?
Man, because like, the level in which that puts y'all on, you know what I'm saying? I heard the yo, shout out by Mike Counts. I listen to the ball all the time.
My man,
so,
yo, that was dope.
Yeah, man.
For real.
That's amazing.
It
would
hit my inbox. I'm like, what are you talking about?
Yeah,
like, bro, he's been talking about it. He loves your name.
Yeah, bro. That's a very big platform, you know what I'm saying, for that.
He won.
Yeah, oh, you won?
That's dope. Mike Counts won.
That's perfect.
And he voted for me.
That's perfect, bro.
Wow.
That's perfect,
man. You know what I'm saying? You got to engage. They do a lot of
shout
events
out.
And shit like that in the city,
like
you know what I'm
it
saying?
Helps.
So,
yeah, they
definitely
help.
Network with, man.
But and that's the beauty of it because it's like What makes what separates you from, you know, everyone else that's doing it? Well, you networking with the people who are doing it. You know right. what I'm saying? And it's like, instead of just being silent about it, it was like, all right, it was blunt sessions, but there was more to it.
Right,
you
know what that's mean? What I remember.
So yeah. it's like, yeah, it's blunt sessions.
Still do the blunt sessions, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah okay. but you know, we take our breaks because, you know, that's what blunt yeah. niggas do.
So what would this be considered? This is just, y'all just.
G Talks. This is Genolexis okay, Talks. Okay. So did this because, like, I got to share.
Yeah.
I don't like sharing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I feel you, man.
Nah, but it's like, it only makes sense because the whole point of Blunt Sessions is to have my homies. You know what I'm saying? Everybody yeah. having a good old time.
Yeah.
It's always with me and Serge always, you know, clowning around, but
right.
it's rare we get Swiss to be in, Bo to be in, Alfie. So it's like, what better way than to just call it one conglomerate? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, this man, is absolutely. This is our government. You know what I mean? Like, Ohio is the United States. So, like, but from that point on, you got. The thing that's dope about it is that it starts changing people's lives in a way because things they right. weren't thinking about, now they are.
Right.
Bo has Bo and Friends. That be on Fridays, you know, every now and then when he come out and do his thing.
Who's that?
Bo, he's another one of...
He got a show called The Fool and Friends now.
Exactly. Okay. So there you go, The Fool and Friends. Fool so, like, friends. Off of that, we got people that's already expanding and doing things yeah. that they didn't think about doing before.
Right.
But, like, you start seeing, you know, how big it could get or if you like it, if you're comfortable mm-hmm. with it. And before you know it, yeah, you can hang it anywhere. You can
hang
use this
it,
thing,
right,
yeah.
Bet.
So you can. I had a soup can, you know what I'm saying, for a bit.
I don't know where it went.
The soup, you ate it, nigga. That's
nah,
where it went.
I ain't eat it, bro.
That's what happened. Nah, but we do whatever, bro. We just have fun. But the main thing is, like, obviously creating. And that's the one of the main things is to be inspired. Like, why should we stay inspired? Well, before it was like, if we're going to do music, where are we going to play it? Where are you going to have an interview? If you got a show or anything like that, like, how you gonna promote it? How you gonna let people know that you got a show going on? You got yeah. music that you're gonna be performing at that show, and right. so on. So it's like I wanted to make it to the point where it's like, you know what, people could go ahead and have a show, promote it, and get the same aspect as they, you know, as a mainstream radio show,
yeah.
just on the underground network, you know, on the podcast stream. But it's like, all right, we get to leading towards that show. We're playing music.
Right.
We're keeping them on a campaign. We're, you know. We promote it in a format where it's like the same feel that you get when Drake about to drop an album or whatever online, you know, on the radio. They get that same feel. Underground rapper, author for a book, whatever it is. Mm-hmm. Even if it's a festival. Right now we got Smokey Jones Smoke Shop.
Oh, y'all doing that?
Yeah, and that's okay. the festival November 2nd. And Wild 98, they spawn, you know, helping push that whatnot on their website. So, you know, however that works out. But
that's
either
basically
way,
what I'm doing, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
Bringing,
yeah.
Bridging gaps in other areas, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, you know, work with more businesses and try to, you know, mix what they're doing with music. Different artists just to bring in different, you know, ideas for the marketing, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
how can we
definitely.
All, you know what I'm saying, share the platforms yeah. the, that we're all on,
definitely.
You know what I'm saying?
And, well, and I'll tell you right now. We the best ones. Nah, what, jump to the mic too.
Oh, my fault.
Nah, you're good. But like,
yeah,
on the real tip, like when it comes to the radio, the reason I feel like we the best, yeah, I said it. Now I'm just stopping. In town, it's because like, not only about, it's not really like where we're at.
Mm-hmm.
It's the experience. What kind of experience do you have? Like you bring it to the table. And that's right. the main thing with us is like, we haven't released any music in a while. But there's a reason why. And it's not like we haven't been doing anything. You know, we've been working.
Mm-hmm.
But the music thing, after once you start learning, like, all right, it's a lot deeper than just dropping good songs. You got to do the boring things behind the scenes, the things that people don't want to do. And that was the one that made, matter of fact, you can put it over here, bro.
Because
this one is more steady.
Real quick.
Bam, you. There you go. Oh, boom, boom. Anyway, but like the main thing is like what kind of formula we're using. You know what I'm saying? If we're going to do music, but let's do it right. But until we have the resources and everything we need to push it, let's push something we do have.
Absolutely.
DJing. We're doing this radio joint. Yeah. We're doing videos,
y'all teams,
photography.
I love what y'all do, man.
Like,
how's the Flahio Eats, by the way, man? Them tacos is fucking
bro,
banging, man.
It's going to come back.
I had to take some time.
Man.
I had to take a hiatus.
You had to take a hiatus?
Yeah, man. I got shows every day
so
now.
Many
so
many things going on, yeah.
Like, well, you got to get somebody else to take over that shit, man. You know what I'm saying?
It's going
to
happen. And you know that was nominated too, bro. And the creative loafing. Yeah, bro. Like, they loved it. So, like, but the thing about it, that's the perfect, you know, a reason why we do what we're doing now. You know what I'm saying? Like, why tie yourself to one thing?
Exactly.
You know
exactly.
You've been DJing too. How's that?
Yeah, great, man. It's going good, man. I'm just building, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like, for me, man, it's just more or less, I'm not necessarily trying to be a DJ. Nah, you know what I'm saying? Just, it's more or less trying to build a platform. I know how to DJ.
Exactly.
But if it fell in my lap, you know what I'm saying? I'll rock with it. You know
that's
what I'm saying?
How I feel. That's how I feel.
But at the end of the day, though, I feel like what I'm trying to do is just build more platforms to eventually give that to someone else once we have the events and everything correlated and running. And hey, yo, give the next little DJ some love. You know what I'm saying? I'll just get this show running. That's, you know what I mean?
I just want to buy niggas out. Kick them out the door. Two, if they want to stay with us, they want to cool.
Straight up. But I believe in letting everybody
buy you out.
Yeah, I believe in letting everybody play their
all
part.
All the times
you
didn't want to let me in the door, tell me watch my mouth. I'm gonna buy you out. I'm gonna buy the whole radio station. That's what I'm gonna do, and I ain't gonna do nothing with it. I'm gonna turn it to like a kids' boys and girls club or something. They're gonna be playing around the satellite dish and sliding all over the place. Watch. You keep playing. It's like,
straight
up. But that's the best part about, like, you know, what we're doing, like how you mentioned, you know, the DJing is just another avenue for you to get the brand out there.
Branding, bro. Yeah, and for artists, man. I'm all about the artists, you know what I'm saying? Then if we can get these venues popping. I'm all about letting people eat, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. If you're a better promoter, fucking venue owner, nigga, please have that shit. That's like, I ain't trying to argue with you, motherfucker.
That's what I say.
But give me a better price so I can get these people in here and get this shit rocking. Because at the end of the day, it's all a business, you know what I'm saying? But you know what I'm saying? All that shit is stress, you know what I'm saying? All the extra shit. So I just stay within my lanes, you know what I'm saying? But make it work.
Yo, and what I peep too is like just one thing at a time.
Yeah.
Whatever's in front of you at that point in time, that's what I work hard at. You know what I'm saying? Like, because tomorrow I may not feel that way. But it's right in front of me. Let me go hard. You know what I'm saying? So if I'm going to be doing a DJ route, whatever, whatever it is.
I see you though. I see you be still doing
the good ass wiper, you know what I'm saying?
Nah, that's love though, man. I see you be doing the you did some shit last week with the like an old folks or something.
Oh yeah, man. Oh, I harass everybody, yo.
That's
old
dope.
People, well, you thought you was safe? Nah, but definitely it was a shout out to them over
in
St. Petersburg. Yeah, yeah, like cause you know everybody always trying to do an event or whatnot, but you never know how it's gonna turn out. Cause somebody has to supply everything, and it's hard to throw an event. Especially if it's like a medical, you know, facilities. Like, how do we make it spice up? You know what I mean? Well, I know. Usually you had a DJ and some loud speakers in the mix. You got yourself a party. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't bring the Crown Apple, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, the old people, I can't have the old people just getting crazy doing.
Yeah.
I tried to do the, you know, Wet Tea concert over there, but you know what I'm saying? They wasn't feeling that nursing home. So it's all right, though. I'm still going to try to clear out the booty contest. So I'm going to try to do the twerk competition at the nursing home.
At the nursing home?
So we're going to see if we get that cleared.
Yo, I'm with it.
You with it?
You with it?
Bet. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, I'm with it. I want them to feel the way, that, you know, we feel now. I want them to experience what they couldn't experience in the 20s and the 30s right now. You know what I'm saying? You couldn't just be twerking in the 50s and the 60s, bro.
You couldn't.
Them cops would go crazy. They wouldn't know if they're sick, the dog on you or fucking sick.
Yeah,
they're 6 inch on you, whatever. You don't know, bro. So, we want them to have the feeling of back in the day. Nah, seriously, real talk. I'm going to get them old people twerking. Let me stop.
You're a fool, bro.
Yo, but the thing about it, man, music is beautiful because, like, right now, it's so much music out there. The pressure isn't as bad as it was. Like, people be like, yo, when you going to drop an album? Why?
It isn't, but I feel like it definitely is still because of social media. And people feel like they have to fucking put on something for social media and you know what I'm saying, still stay guarded in certain ways, you know what I'm saying? But I definitely feel you, the freedom to release, the freedom to be creative is there now.
But
you
think
can
about
fucking
it.
Do that shit,
like,
nasty.
And I hear that because I used to be on the same tip. Then I started doing events that have nothing to do with music, take photos, and then I post them, and I got a billion people following me. I do not know who they are. So I was like, you know what, is it really the music or is it just the appeal, just the look? And that's where I started focusing more on other things. Because I'm still doing music, and we have music, actually.
You're absolutely right, brother.
I want to record it somewhere else. I want the quality to be where it's at. But now, what was the problem before was like, all right, like, dang, we're going to lose our fan base because they want to hear more music, more material and stuff like that, which is true. You want to be able to give content. But at the same time, what kind of content? Is it quality content? Because if I don't drop, you know, the last time I dropped an album was actually this year. But to me, I'm still saying it's like, I want to be more on it. Because, like, if I'm comparing Genolexis dropping music compared to Drake dropping music, Drake might have dropped one album or, you know, this year, but he's also had multiple singles and other prominent artists, you know, albums. So it's like, that's one of the main things. It's like, okay, So I could pressure myself and be like, yo, let me drop this album quick. Let me drop a single quick. Or I could be like, what do I have right now? Instead of forcing the inspiration, I have other people who are inspired by what I do. And they want me on their track.
Yeah.
Kind of like the Drake situation. There's right. people that like Drake. If they got the budget or whatever, they get him on their track.
Yeah.
So now if I'm on that level, I'd rather use their fan base. Mm-hmm. So now when it's time for me to release my music, it's going to be cool because now I've been dealing with all these other artists. You know what I'm saying? And whoever's listening, yo, take notes. Because it's not like this don't didn't come out my ass. I was researching this shit like this. You know what I'm saying? Like from books from people who already established. They're already moving.
Yeah.
So it's like, and now I want to be able to bring the attention. Like I'm a father. I'm a family man. So it's like, there's other rappers who are in the same position. If I was in, you know, a younger guy and I was doing a show like that and I could talk about more about, we could be bachelor. We're going to be in the club and blah, blah. I don't got time for that. I be in the club, but that's because I'm working. You know what I'm saying? It's not because, like, we want to be popping bottles all the time. But now while I'm there, I'm going to do a video like I am popping bottles. I'm going to go ahead and make people know, like, hey, around the world, look, I'm doing something. In real life, I'm fucking working.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But at least I put a little bit of that time towards the music.
I feel
so by the time we're ready to drop something, you know what I'm saying?
It's and that's what you're relevant. To kind of go back to what you said, it's really about the appeal. And that's really what I'm, you know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, bro, you can do music all day.
That's
what makes you cool, what makes you whatever the fuck, is the fact that you do music as well.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Bro.
So you can choose either or. It's all about how you appeal.
And then the thing is your quality. Because what you mentioned, like, your quality in the studio. That's one of the main reasons. Like, that's why we started linking up. Because I'm like, man, that very first track, it wasn't even my track. It was someone else's track I was doing, verse four.
Yeah, I remember that.
But I'm like, I'm like, yo, this was dope. But from that point on, I'm like, yo, I gotta link up with him. Because this quality is the main thing. You know what I'm saying? Definitely. Because I know a lot of people that got studio. I got people right now probably looking like, yo, you didn't mention my studio. And that's cool. Yeah. I got you. But everybody got a different... You know, medium. Everybody got a different platform. However they work, whatever their canvas is different.
Right.
So it ain't knocking nobody that got a studio. It's just that, how do you feel when you're there? It's different. It's not like
absolutely.
I can't get along with them.
The vibe. You know what I'm saying? I say that all the time. I ain't going to get everybody mixed right. That's something I had to take. I had to realize, you know what I'm saying, early.
Yeah,
right?
Everyone's different.
You know what I'm saying? 8 out of 10, I'm getting them shits right, goddamn
it. That's it. And that's it.
And that's all that matters to me.
And consistent, like,
consistency.
Content consistency. Yeah. That's one of the main things. It's like,
gotta do that.
You got to remind people that you are doing what you are. You like, why am I the shit? Because this is why. like, look, I do this, but... I don't just do this. I actually work hard. I actually study.
Right.
You know, the craft. And then
exactly. And
you
so
release.
That's kind of like you were saying. It gets going back. It's really just all about that, man. Knowing what you... Because you can be a father popping bottles and be a bachelor and all that
exactly.
shit. And you can still have a million followers.
That's
fuck
it.
With you. So
that's
it's just a matter of how you appeal, how you push it, how you present it. You know what I'm saying?
Because
everybody wants to be sold at the end of the goddamn day.
Yeah, real talk.
You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, bro, you just, you know, you sell it right. You live that shit.
But
you gotta make sure you don't step on no toes at the same
real
time.
Real talk.
You know what I mean?
Man, and that one thing I started looking at, dog, don't even worry about toast.
Don't
worry about it. Because if you're really working from your heart,
that's real shit.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
I feel the same way.
Usually when
that
happens, it's not intentional.
Yeah.
And then they know it, but because of the simple fact, it's like, dang, man, they trying to do something, but you seem to be shining brighter than them.
Mm.
They seem like they was working harder, but why is this guy getting the attention that I'm not, you know, I've been doing this longer. I've had that. But it's just like, you keep moving.
Yeah, it depends
when
on what you're trying
to
do, I guess. But when it comes to that shit.
How can I help you?
Yeah.
If that's how you feel about it, that's how I've been doing. Like, I don't be for nobody. There's been times where it's like, hey, there's an idea. That's what
I'm talking. I'm talking more within a circle, I guess. You know what I'm saying?
No, fuck facts.
That.
My
analogy to business and running, you know what I'm saying, people doing music or a studio and a studio down the street.
Yeah.
It's not about there's a studio down the street. It's
exactly.
A fact.
Y'all in it together.
There's a. I always
facts.
Do an analogy of CBS
especially
and CBS
studio,
and Walgreens.
I deal with a lot of nonsense.
Yeah,
with that.
Just
and
the music
crazy.
Industry in general.
Yeah, yeah.
But always compared to CBS and
Walgreens.
Like, nigga, they do the same shit. They're across the street on every corner. So it's like end of the day, bro. It's not about what they do, it's how they doing it.
Oh, she interviewing too, apparently.
Yeah, yeah. So it's really so I ain't worried about the toes. I'm worried about more or less within a circle.
We're
supposed to be loyal.
Definitely.
You know what
definitely.
I'm saying? Let's like that's why I appreciate y'all boys. Y'all,
yeah,
y'all
definitely.
Do, y'all do that shit for real. Y'all
bro,
got that loyalty thing down.
That
for
thing
real.
And that's what it is, my man. Thank you. Because like people want to know like how you keep producing quality material. Well, you look at these artists where they can't drop another, you know, banger because they don't have you really want to be in this convo. It's
convo.
All good though. I'm like, hey, that's Marley, y'all, by the way.
What's
she's
up,
just
Marley?
Doing her thing. Marley just chilling. But like, you know, you trying to capture the same magic that created the, you know, the oomph in the first place.
Yeah.
And it's like, if you don't have that same people around you, or the vibe or the atmosphere that you used before to create that classic, right, it's going to be hard to keep releasing that
part.
So that's, I start noticing, like, you know, especially for me, like, I'm writing again. It's been a while since I've been, like, having to pay attention to, okay, I'm going to write for an album. Like, writing a song is, or it's already tough because it's like, man, I don't know when I'm going to release the next song. But when you start writing an album, it's like, all right, I'm releasing this song and it's about that, but the next song is not going to be about that. It may be similar, but it's not. So it's like, how do we make all these songs come together and then they're going to be this project? So I say, you know what? I have the songs. Now let me get the inspiration back. I have the ideas and whatnot. I still got to write down to a lot of them. But what made me excited back then? What was it? 2010, the earthquake happened. The Haitian earthquake. Right. That's what really got the fire on my ass.
Because
it's like, now it's my home. I'm seeing people dealing with craziness. So it's like, what better way can I... can I make a good, you know, just represent my people in the right way, and at the same time represent hip hop, represent good positive music, you know, and it, you know, bring real issues at the same time while having fun. So like, bringing it back to stuff like that. But then again, that was how many years ago? So I can't be using the same thing when so many things are happening now. There's so many things I could talk about. It's not just that. So now it's to the point where it's like, all right, let me not focus so much on. Right now, there's binge watching. There's the, all these shows are out. There's, it's easy to be like, yo, I want to know what they talking about. I want to know. But at the same time, it's like, at the same time, I want to be the power. I want to be the Game of Thrones. I want to be one, you know what I'm saying? Like, so like, but how the hell can I be that if I'm watching them niggas do their thing? So that's where it's like, for me, I got to be able to be like,
I feel you.
Discipline myself. Yeah, I feel you, man. The hardest part. So
you do now, good though, bro. You do good.
Thank you, man. But I know I could do better. And I know, knowing that other people are inspired by what I do, it's my job to do better. Because how can they get better if I'm bullshitting? You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I got to put it, be disciplined. I gotta set alarms on my phone. I gotta.
Oh yeah, you know what I'm saying.
Like whatever it is, to, you know, I'm gonna be the parent and whatnot. But at the same time, like, also be on my ass.
Yeah.
There's other people that's like, they putting everything that they believe in to this, all because they saw a video of me. You know what I'm saying? Or, or heard a song or whatever. You know, over the rainbow. You know, whatever it is, like, it's something that I created that, you know, gave them that drive. So when they give up, what's going to happen if I give up?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely, man. So that's what it's about, man. Inspiring.
That's why you're here, because somebody's going to be on there and they're going to be like, yo, this is, look how many people were on here. Like, my aunt, what's good? Yeah. There's so many people that, you know what I'm saying, that you never know who's watching till later. You know what I'm saying?
And that's real.
And these are people that just happen to just, you know, if they say whatever they say, that's cool. You'll never know who's watching.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Or who's, you know, inspired by you. But you know how you feel when you don't do what you love doing.
Yeah, that's where it's at, you know? That's real. Right, girl? Right?
But, yo, movies. You like movies? I like talking about movies all the time. I do. Start with fucking Conan.
I'm sorry, huh?
No, you good. You do your thing. Do your thing.
I watch movies, man. I just, honestly, I don't, I haven't lately, man. I've been busy.
I was talking about binge watching shit, but now I'm thinking like,
That's probably more my thing now. Actually, I'd rather binge watch something.
Yeah, instead of just,
yeah, a movie, bro, I get bored quick.
I feel you. I gotta be real
interested. I'll be doing some other shit. Yeah, yeah, I'll be.
I like old movies, though. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, me too, man. I'm old school like that.
The story, I was watching Django. I was mentioning that earlier. Someone go back to that. There's a part in Django, I freaking loved it. And I seen it before, but I never paid attention to, like, this last time I was watching it. So I'm like, it was dope. The dude, like, they find out, oh, that was a great movie, bro. It was a great movie. Django! Yo, I freaking promote that all day. But anyway, but like, and I mean, come on, man. The black, the nigga, he rides off with his woman. Come on, son.
You got a baby, bro. You got a baby.
Yeah, I do. I got a baby because of Django. I got a baby because of Django. You know what I'm saying? Let me stop. But, like, there's a part where you think, oh, man, they bad guys got him. And then Samuel comes in there. He does it so well because movies nowadays, they gotta focus with special effects. They got to get a big name person. They got to force people to go to the... I felt like I was forced to go to Marvel to watch Endgame. The first one, I cried out that movie. I said it. It put tears in my eyes. But, like, Endgame, which was cool and everything, but I felt like the dialogue in the first one was a lot better. It seemed like, to me, I felt more like attached to each character. So that's what made me want to see Endgame, because the dialogue and freaking the bad guy, his dialogue, his, like, his speech is just, it made you want to root for the bad guy. You know what I'm saying? Because it was a good dialogue that whenever he spoke, it wasn't for long, but it was enough for you to even catch a quote like, yo, that's dope. So now, Django. Mm-hmm. He says, he catches a guy, one of the henchmen about to chop your man's, you know, thing off. So he's like, nah. Let, you know, Miss such and such needs you back in the house. All right, boom, man takes off. And he sits down in front of Jamie Foxx. He's like, hey, you know, I don't know what it is with them wanting to chop people's thing off, whatnot. You know, that's always seems to be the go-to, you know, the last resort. That's what we're going to do. We're going to take them out. You know what I'm saying? And he's like, you know what? Rather than we do that, I thought something better. I thought we sell you to this man who's going to have you working in the mines. And then when you work in there, you work there till you old and dry. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Now, you ain't never going to see that scene. But the way he broke it down, you could picture that scene. Yeah. To the point you're like, dang, how he going to get out this situation? So you never see the scene, see though. But because the dialogue, because the acting, because Snapchat the way they put quick, the words, what's good?
Snapchat love.
For our radio.
Snapchat love.
Man. There's a live on Snapchat?
Live on Snapchat. We on Flow High Your Radio.
Here, man.
Let's go.
Good afternoon. I gave up my Snapchat a while ago.
Yo, man, I got back on there. I'm still, I don't know what's going on. I'm trying. I just like try to record random joints, like paying bills and getting gas, yeah. Like boring things.
Yeah. So let's get back to like, I want to talk more about this. I know we follow kind of the same people on Facebook.
Yeah, man.
I don't know if y'all talked about it yet on the station with anybody or anything like that. How do y'all feel about the whole promoter artist situation? You know what I mean? Because personally for me,
well, what is it though? I don't even know what's going on.
Yeah. Well, just from what I've been
let people know.
And shit. Oh, thank you. You're a radio guy.
You're good.
You're good. So basically, I guess there's a promoter artist type of situation that artists feeling like they should be getting paid for the services, you know, for the performance and whatever.
Yeah, that's not some part of it, but yeah, just you know, so people that don't know.
Yeah, so you know, it's definitely a thing, you know. Although I can understand, you know, coming from as a businessman, I understand the business, you know what I'm saying? A business, any fucking business.
So, is it, all right, just to kind of reiterate.
All right.
It's about the promoters. Sorry. No, you're good. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's about, like, the promoters charging artists.
Yeah. Exactly.
To rock.
That's what I meant to say.
And then now, artists having a problem with that because they feel like they should come out to a spot that's already promoted and ready to go.
Right.
And then a promoter's standpoint is like, hey, I'm giving you a platform anyway. So, what's the problem with you paying? Because I need this money to help me recoup and do whatever. Make the show better or whatever the case may be.
Right.
Pay the main act.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
So, I say where I stand. And you go
ahead. Yeah, I mean, you know, where I stand with it, you know, I'm not really... I understand. I understand where they're coming from. I definitely understand that. But being, you know, someone that's, you know, put together shows before... I definitely understand why it's done, you know what I'm saying? Especially when you get an artist that has no particular stage presence, you know what I'm saying? Has no particular care for, or has no show mix, or has no preparation for where they feel, where a promoter or any person is booking this person should feel like they're ready for that. You know what I'm saying? So then, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes it can become a loss to not only your show, but that venue.
Yeah.
So there's so many different aspects to where that's, why that's so serious. And I definitely understand the artist side of it. Because, you know, we're all struggling artists and all that extra stuff, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, man, I feel like with Tampa, man, this is a testing market, in my opinion, man. Like, it's not really a market where you're getting, you know, we're not getting, you know, power A&Rs and executives coming here every day or
what we actually do is just that because we keep our, I mean, this is opinion, it's all opinion. Gino opinion. We think too small for our city.
Hmm.
Like, It don't stop all these companies from investing in the city.
Mm-hmm.
Super Bowl. It don't stop, you know.
When is that, by the way?
Olympics or whatever in 2 years or whatnot, 2021.
That's going to be amazing. But like, that's for me, bro. Yeah. I'm just letting motherfuckers know. For me, I'm sure his like, yo, I'm getting ready. I'm Flow High Eats. I'm probably Eats.
Bro. Nigga, I already put up the word a couple venues.
Yo.
It's going to happen. I'm trying to have a show.
Absolutely.
That Friday night, because the Saturday night is going to be like the Puff Daddies and all them joints. Mm-hmm. People ain't gonna come to that. But if we do like a Thursday, Friday night,
jumping, bro. We gotta be ready, son. We gotta be ready. You know what I'm saying?
Now to go with these guys. The thing is, like, whoever's thinking that, you know, we're still up and coming, that's dead. We're there. We're already there.
Yeah, this is a great city, man.
We got the biggest hip-hop artist talking about Tampa.
Yeah, this city is great.
We got Killer Mike on the Revolt thing. Mm-hmm. He mentioned Tampa.
Oh, he did?
Yeah. So, like, Tampa's already there. The thing is, we've been in the music industry in Tampa so long without breaking out and seeing how big Tampa is that we're still thinking we need a Hot 97. We already have it.
Yeah.
The thing is, we have all those platforms. So it's like we got all those guys that can bring those guys here. Rick Ross from, you know, Broward County or whatever. Duval from Duval.
Shout out to Broward County, too. That's where I'm from, man. Yes, sir.
Yeah, you know, that's family. But, like, we got to start worrying about what the person across this town is doing. Yeah. And start worrying about what we doing.
Yeah, man.
Because the thing is, like, for the artists who have a problem with people that's charging whatever, don't perform that at the show.
You know what I'm saying?
Don't pay that art promoter. Bro, simple. Because there's other artists that will. So you can't knock a promoter for doing how he works. If he, and the thing is, absolutely. Now, if you're a brand new promoter, then of course, you got to prove, you know, why should people even mess with you? You know what I'm saying? I understand that. But if you are a new promoter, you bring in quality acts.
Yeah.
Yo, what you do with that time that you have this quality act in the city with a packed crowd, it's on you.
Yeah.
Because now if you're paying that much money to go, you know, make sure you're in a packed house or whatever the case may be, then you also provide that camera.
Right.
You provide your team to do what they got to do and push you because it's your show too.
Exactly. So it's like, I tell people that all the time. You, you can't be focused on that. There's so many ways to eat off.
Be happy you got a platform.
Yeah, be happy, bro. There's so many ways to eat off that shit.
In order to go open up for that same character in another city, you're paying well over $1,000. Mm-hmm. And we're not talking about gas, getting there, room, board, wherever you're going to be staying at, how much you're going to eat, how much you got to get back home.
Yeah.
It's a lot more. So if somebody's going to give you the opportunity to pay $750, $900, $300, whatever it is, just to open up, maybe get a chance to talk to this guy, whatever the case is, don't knock him. It's the game. You can't knock the hustle. You know what I'm saying? Don't like the game? Play another one. But it's like we're in the city.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, there's people that would love to pay that much just to come to Florida.
Right.
And open up for that kind of act.
Bruh.
But we're already here. We're already in a tourist location.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
People need to get used to the fact that you got paid.
The best performance that I paid for this year for an artist was that the Baby Goss show from my boy Jason Kline, man. We still eating off that.
Go.
Like, we still got contacts and shit building up off that motherfucker.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? The main thing is like people need to see, like, on an artist's standpoint, like, it's not the promoter's job to fill the club. He's going to go ahead and do what he can, and the club got to fill the club too. The promoter's going to fill the, you know, he's going to do what he can to fill it, but the promoter's there to give an experience.
Absolutely.
That's what people forget. If you're going to say, oh, I'm going to promote this type of show, I can only do so much. I can't bring everybody through the door. I'm bringing in the entertainment. I'm bringing in the DJ. I'm bringing in this, that, da, da, da. So it's like, I'm already bringing stuff in. So it's the venue. It's the artist. It's whoever is there that's going to be eating off of this event.
Yeah.
So it's like, whatever happened when the event happens, that's on whoever now. You know, figure it out. You know,
that's another thing, too.
Nah, yeah. You know, it's on them.
The difference between showcase, open...
10 minutes, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Showcase, open mic, and events.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's the difference.
That's a lot of people fucking difference, bro. Man.
I think what the whole situation was is somebody was charging artists just for something that was regular. There was no cash prize. There was no... big name coming in, even a medium-sized name coming in. I think they were just charging.
A regular, charging just for a regular venue.
And I can see that. I wouldn't charge.
The promoter's issue now.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the issue with the promoter.
It all depends on the situation. So, personally, I look at it, I would never charge an artist to perform unless I got a big name coming.
That's
absolutely.
It.
Or if I'm giving out a cash prize.
Yeah. But honestly, too, bro, if y'all artists paying that much money, nigga, why? Like, there's so many resources that you could use that hundreds of dollars online and get, like, real clout. You can actually get booked to do a venue that someone else is not even worrying if you're bringing people.
And also,
they just want you to come.
A lot of the problems, too, with artists, and I found this out the first two shows I did because I was Mr. Pay the Artist.
Yeah.
I was like, that's my thing.
Same.
I want to make sure that all the city knows that I pay all the artists.
Yep.
Right.
But then when you pay these artists, they don't promote.
Nope. They don't do
share
nothing.
The flyer.
Yep.
They don't care because they already got
their
money.
They already got money. So
don't
worry about the show.
The way I do it now.
Ain't that some shit?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But they don't want to tell you that.
Yeah.
Because the thing is, I even had the most recent Beats and Eats. Yeah. We had an issue with he's probably one of the biggest name artists in Tampa.
Really?
I'm not going to say his name because he don't deserve to shine.
Really?
But everybody, the way I had the Beats and Eats set up.
And he's known to be a crab.
He is a crab.
God
damn
it.
He's not known. He is a crab.
Yeah, he is.
But
Jesus,
I gave out the way I had it after the first Beats and Eats. I put that one on because I met somebody.
I gave you a TV, nigga.
No, go ahead.
I met somebody who is affiliated with this big promotional company down in Miami.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, yo, can you put together a show, blah, blah. I had all the artists come. That was the first show that I didn't get to compensate the artists.
Mm.
It was a dope show. There were some hiccups in it. It was the first one I actually put together.
Mm-hmm.
I immediately learned from now on, I'm going to give the artist tickets. Y'all sell them. So that way, A, you're getting money. B, you're bringing people in the door. Mm-hmm. Now you're going to promote something. Now this guy, not going to say his name.
Damn, I want to know his name.
I gave him...
Off air, please.
Oh, I had everybody's tickets in this envelope. Had it wrapped, had the name on it. Everybody came and got their tickets. This guy never came and got his tickets. I hit him up numerous times. Never picked up his tickets. Day of the show, he hits me up. Oh, I'm going to be running late. I'm stuck at work. Cool, no problem. About 12 o'clock rolls around. His spot already done came and went. Because he wanted... I was going to put him on primetime spot. Uh-huh. You the headliner.
We had people didn't show in the building. Up.
He comes to the show. It's 12 o'clock. He's like, hey... How do I get? I gotta give Gino. I gotta give the DJ the music. You ain't email him the music yet.
Nope.
You're supposed to be a professional. You're supposed to be the guy that's been doing this the longest.
Wow. Yep.
So I had to go on stage, give Gino the music while I got the comedian performing. So that looks weird. But I gave Gino the music. You know what I mean? I gave the comedian like an extra 10 minutes on his set because he was killing it. Meanwhile, this guy's getting drunk at the bar. He starts talking shit about how come he's still on stage.
Yo.
Then. Yo, he starts. You go ahead.
He starts getting loud with it. He
starts heckling.
Yeah.
Our act. Basically, his co-performer.
Yeah.
He's heckling. All right.
Cool. Yeah. So, I'm like, all right. He finishes up. He's like, hey, come here real quick. So, I go to the bar. I meet him. He's like, I'm not going to be able to go on stage. So, fuck you mean you're not going to be able to go on stage? Oh, well, you know, this is unprofessional, and there's barely anybody here. It's 1 o'clock, and I'm like, well, you know, if you would have came and got your tickets, you would have at least 20 people here to support you. There's still people here, but because since it's not 30 or 40 people, now all of a sudden you can't rock.
You can't do it.
So, you showed up late. Well, A, you didn't get your tickets. B, you never shared the flyer that you were on. C, you showed up an hour and a half late.
But he booty riding the next freaking event that he wasn't even like freaking like a part of.
And then you call me unprofessional because of what? Because you didn't do your job? And you're supposed to be one of the top dogs in the city. So I was just like, all right, now I know who I can't rock with. And it's a shame because he's the dope. He's by far one of the dopest lyrically in the city.
Damn it, man.
But he's killing his own opportunities.
Wow.
He's been on Sway in the morning a couple of times. Let me give some hints.
Really?
You know what I mean? He does a lot, but these type of events, you have no professionalism, and you cannot turn that around on me and say, I don't.
Mm.
My job is not to pack this place. My job is to pay the DJ, pay the venue, press up all the tickets for everybody to go out there and make their money, because most artists, I want $50. Now check it out. I'm giving you 20 tickets, $10 a pop. You make $200. And on top of that, I set the door price at $15. So you giving them $5.
You make
discount.
More money doing like you.
You make more that money than that I
make
would
more
make
more money. Yes. Doing it that way, because ain't nobody. Usually people are like, yo, you can make $5. You make $2 or whatever. You make $1 a ticket.
A lot of but like a lot of the promoters will sell. Bread. They will sell artist tickets to turn around and sell.
Exactly.
I'm not selling y'all shit. I'm giving you tickets so you can make $200. I'll be lucky if I pull $200 at the night.
But long story short, that's why you just can't rock with everybody.
Yeah, you can't.
I mean, sometimes people think you know, you're rolling over toes, but you're not. It's just like you stay with a circle, like you mentioned, cutting up the fat. Because the thing about it is, like, you try to expand with the promoter and the artist situation. That's just, an example, because I wanted to stick with that. I'm happy you brought that out before we shut that down, because that's what we do. We like to inform, crack jokes and whatnot, but make sure somebody gets something that they could use that could help them out. But, like, But, you know, and things happen. You know what I'm saying? It's all love to all the arts. They'll be falling apart. You know, things fall out and whatever. But, you know, crab shit is crab shit. You're always going to be a crab regardless of where you're at. You know what I'm saying? You could lick that nigga off the Arctic Ocean and drop him in the Antarctica, and that nigga is still a crab. So, like, there's just people that's like that. But once you realize who you got around you, it's going to save you a lot of time because of the simple fact that you keep that shit clean. You filter out the trash. And that's what we do here, man. We filter out the trash.
Yeah, it's crazy, man, because it's like you wouldn't expect that from somebody.
I would, because I said it.
you said it, but you know what I'm saying? I'm also looking at it from the perspective of, it's
chance.
Like, come on, bro, you're on the flyer, bro.
Yeah, I know.
It's like, you got to be more, you were one of the most relevant. And the fact is, this guy came at me a few months prior because I was doing the food joint.
You know what I mean? Joint, I was doing Flo Highly Eats.
But something that he wasn't even doing.
So he was just upset. Like,
just clouting.
He was upset because the venue that booked me already has a guy that does it. But because since he was fucking up, they booked me. Wow. So now he was mad at me because he's like, why
That's the funny thing.
I'm like, come on, people bro, are corny, funny. Bro.
We're leaving, baby.
And this is the same person that I done blessed and gave him cash when he was going out to Sway. I'm like, bro, I'm the last person you should ever come at.
I gave you a fucking 50-inch TV, bro.
You know what I'm saying?
A 40-inch with the remote. I came to your spot, bro.
It dropped it off.
You can come on. I dropped it off.
And this is how you treat
this
us?
Is how you. This is what I get. This is what I get.
Nah, but it's cool because that just shows that it shows you the people who are really about this life and the people who just act like they bought it.
Yeah. I could be using that 40-inch right now.
Because I know a lot of guys who I would give those 20 tickets to that don't have a car that'll walk up to where I'm at to get those tickets.
People were happy. The people that made their money that night, they were happy.
Yeah, they were the ones
that
were out
there working. Job. So, but the whole purpose is, that's why we do what we do, because we talk shit and we back it the fuck up. Because it's a simple fact, for so long, people have been talking this and talking that, but like, where do you back it up? Where's your numbers? Where's your proof? Podcast is cool, and because people could... They could go back. Like, hey, what was he talking about? Let's find out. Even me, I post some crazy shit online. Somebody be catching me. Like, hey, you posted this years ago about this. Yeah, all right, so what? I changed my mind now.
Yeah, but I'm different now. What?
You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. But own up to it. There's people out here that they be acting like they about the city. No, you're not. Tell people you about the money. Tell people, don't act like you care and all this shit. Like, let people know from the jump what you about. So I know, like, oh, you trying to rob me. All right, bet. I'm cool. You know, whatever it is. But people be acting like they're your friends just to get on the platform or just to get some shout or some shares and whatnot. But they don't give two shits about you, bro.
Yeah, bro.
Look at them people that... You don't know who to pay attention to? When you put your photos of your kids online? Mm-hmm. Them people.
The ones that like it.
The people that like it.
Yeah.
The ones that tell you happy birthday.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, exactly. Yeah, the one that go out there. I called this nigga. He didn't even pick up the phone. You know what I'm saying? Everybody was going online. I called this nigga. I did the old school shit.
I'm like,
yeah, I call this nigga.
Yeah. But those are the people, like I said, those are the people, and those are the ones that surprised. I got a lot of people that texted me, and I was like, you could have easily just went on Facebook, HBD.
Yeah, the easy route.
But there's people that got my contact and hit me up directly.
Yeah,
I was
that's
like,
it.
Like, and there's people that have constantly hit me up to bring to promote their events. Couldn't find me nowhere.
Yo. Damn. All the time though, you know about them people, man. They go on your DM like, hey, listen to this. But you scroll through the history, you ain't never talked to this nigga in your life.
Yeah.
But they want you to like their page.
Yeah.
Do this, scratch my back, like, nigga. Brush your teeth.
You gonna spam
demanding me shit? Yeah. Nah, but yo, once again, let people know where to find you. I'm happy we had you here. This shit was fun. It was last minute, impromptu. Loved it.
Yeah, man. Thanks for having me. J Doe, International Doe on Instagram. And on Snapchat, definitely look me up. Private OT Studios on Instagram.
Yeah.
Definitely look me up there. And
clear quality.
Yeah, man. And Dream Design and Development, DDD_LLC on Instagram.
Yeah.
Definitely reach out. You know what I'm saying? We definitely want to help.
Get DJ
new,
too.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And get the new wave of new artists coming out, man. We definitely going to work with them, man. And get them on the circuit. Get them involved with Flow High and everything,
going big, man.
Man.
Y'all, listen. Your Super Bowl. Y'all want to be fucking with us. I know people got strip clubs and all that.
Yeah, I got something
it's
I want to
cool.
do.
We got that, but we got something bigger. Like, bigger. And we got great news coming up for the month of November. You're going to like that. If y'all been following it with us the last couple of years, you know what time it is. October, November, you know what time it is. I'm just going to give you a hint. Nights moves when it's, I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. I was trying to be clever about it, but now I just sounded corny. You know what I'm saying? Oh, it just sounded corny. I was trying to be slick with it, but nah, it didn't work. Just know we're going to be there doing our thing. So make sure y'all stay tuned, because we're going to have the interviews, we're going to have the video rolling, and the whole nine. It's October. We also got the Smoke Shop Festival coming soon, and October is Halloween time, so we got a Halloween special coming. I'm going to do a special Halloween Genolexis episode. I got guests coming in. That's going to be dope. So y'all stay tuned for that. That's going to be amazing. We're going to have fun. And the next episode, I'm going to do a horror movie episode. So next episode, y'all stay tune to that. That's going to be fun because I've been planning that for a while. And that's about it. Serge, you want to say anything?
Nah, that's it.
My man. J Doe, you want to say anything?
Peace and blessings.
That's what's up. Marley, you want to say anything?
Nah, she's quiet.
Of course.
She'll be yapping the whole time. Now you quiet.
Of course. Well, on that note, thank everybody for joining. Hey, we got Fort Battle. Or what you want to end it with? Any song, whatever you got.
I got it. Let's go.
All right, bet. You guys are amazing. Much love, Flew High Radio, Genolexis Talks. We out.
Genolexis Talks. We do what the fuck we want. Because we do what the fuck we want on Genolexis Talks.
Because I'm a stud.